Hi guys, it's been a few days since I actually picked the camera up for various reasons. One, I've been feeling a little down in the dumps. Just for various reasons. And I'm just sorting the PC out because I've just got in the door from Mum's. And I haven't had anything to talk about, really, because I haven't done anything. I've been just lurking around in the flat. Anyway, hello. No idea who you are, but... I've had me as a friend. Nope, it may have sold. So I've put the Honda up for sale. I haven't got, well, I've got the time, but I just haven't got the money to do it. Anyway, and someone should be picking it up tomorrow. I've just got to whack the back wheel back on, pump it up, put the exhaust back on, basically put those few bits back together on it, and that could be collected. I did get today another LED bulb, exactly the same as what I put in my hallway, and I've put it in. The lamp. You just about see it up there in all its glory. Exactly the same as what I put in the hallway. Just the pack. The Lidl's have still got them. £2.99 or two for £5. And I'd rather spend that £2.99 and not have to worry about it, well, for quite some time, because they are supposed to have quite a lifespan. Long lifespan, that is. Than keep spending £1.99 as often as I am just to replace the filament type bulbs I was using and bloody things. It blows at least one every month. Anyway, that's that bit. I bought a spare extension socket at home, extension outlet, whatever you may know them as. Because I'll probably need one closer to Christmas. And Biggles has given me a bunch of games, video games. So I'm just going to park my ass on the floor and we'll have a look. There's some Xbox games, but I don't have an Xbox. Yeah, and they're football games as well, so I'm not sure what I'll do with these. I may actually donate these to a charity. Because I'm feeling benevolent today. Yeah, see more football game, football game, football game. I'm not into me football, so they're no good to me. There's one PlayStation 1 game. I've already got this one, so... I was going to keep the case, but that's not very good, so... That can go in the charity pile. I've got a charity in town that I'd like to give it to. The rest is all PlayStation 2. I'm saving the best to last, by the way. What have we got? SX Superstar. Not really my cup of tea, but I wouldn't mind giving that a go. The Simpsons Hit and Run. Apparently that is a good game, according to my brother. I've never played it. I've already got this, so I'm going to check the disc condition and see if it's worth eBay. There's another football game. I can go in the donation pile, because I don't do... I'm not into football games or anything like that. I'm not really into football. And what have we got? Another one. I've got another Simpsons Hit and Run. I'll see which is what the discs are like, and... If one's good enough to go and donate, and that, or if they're both good, then I'll probably sell one and we'll try and sell one on eBay. And if not, it'll just get donated to charity. Lord of the Rings, that's rattling, something's rattling around in there anyway. Yeah, the disc is. So I don't know what the disc condition is like on any of these. Next, Star Trek Voyager Elite Force. Now, it's a shame my friend from France isn't still here, because he likes Star Trek, so... the PlayStation 2 game, no point sending him. But I've got... I am Star Trek game for the PC that I might send him. If he wants it. Buzz, the Mega Quiz. I don't have the controllers for this, but they're easy enough to get hold of. Guitar Hero 3. Legends of Rock. I wouldn't mind getting the guitars for that. What we got? King Kong. Probably not my cup of tea, but I can go there. Tony Hawk's American Wasteland. Again, probably not my cup of tea, but might be something a bit different. It's just the football games I'm really not interested in. Guitar Hero 2. And the last one in the bag, Need for Speed Underground 2. I think I've got this one, and I've got some Need for Speeds. So, what a nice little pile of PlayStation 2 games there to add to the collection. That Biggles gave me today. I gave him a bag of cable I'd collected up. So I've been having to sort out. I had so many SCART leads and computer USB cables of various types. And multiples of the same type. I just shredded some up and took in the cables. Anyway, I do have another retro computer for the collection. And it was a bargain. Or I think it was a bargain anyway. It is a Sinclair Spectrum or ZX Spectrum Plus. So I don't know if there's a difference with the plus. Complete with power adapter, and a user guide, which is actually pretty handy because I haven't got the foggiest idea how to use these old computers. I haven't got a clue. But that is the price I paid. That won't focus very well. It's £20. And the guy had four of these ZX Spectrums in there. I don't know if they are all the plus or what, but he had the smaller version as well, which is basically the same, but got a lot of this all trimmed off, with a tape deck, so I know he'd have wanted a lot more than the £20 mark. There was one there that didn't seem to have a power adapter with it, but it did have the ZX Spectrum user guide. There was another one on the shelf, which had all the cable and all the power adapter and guide. Same price, and there was this one. I picked this one. I haven't tried it yet, but he wouldn't ask that sort of money for something that doesn't work, because I've had stuff out of there before, so I do trust the guy. So that is something I might take it into the bedroom later and play with that. I might save it till tomorrow. The moped, you should be picking it up at about 5 o'clock tomorrow. He is local. I don't want to sell it, but the bottom line is the chances are very high that it's just going to sit in there for years. Just sitting there, waiting to be done. And that's not fair to keep it there. And it's taken up space, and I'd rather sell it to someone who's actually going to do something with it. I can always, you know, buy something else in the future. It's not the end of the world. But I'm basically going to get what I paid for it. I'm selling it for what I paid for. So I'm not losing and I'm not gaining. So that's not actually bad in my book. Not best, but not bad. Hopefully I'll have £27 going into my bank account tomorrow night, I hope. In theory, it should, anyway. I've got some posting to do tomorrow. I think I'll do that. Oh, pardon me. As soon as I've had breakfast. And I've decided what I'm going to have for breakfast. Not quite sure yet. Whew. That was a bit of a smelly one. Cool. There is one good thing, you know, when I have my little depressed moods. What? You've got food. I fed you. And that is that, especially last night, I had a bit of a tidy up in the bedroom with all those cables, which was quite therapeutic. And I was in such a mood that I didn't want to keep anything. I didn't think, I better keep that just as a spare. I was just like, right, I'll keep two or three of each cable as a spare, apart from the Ethernet cables. I kept all those. No, I didn't. I scrapped one because that was crap. All the Ethernet cables I kept because I've got all those computers in the bedroom, and eventually I'd like to run an RJ45 from here into the bedroom. I should have left the one that was already in there. Already in there. One that I'd hung up in here before. I should have just left that in here. But never mind. Yeah. So I've got all those there. And it would have been nice just to tinker. Pardon me. On that. I think I may actually move that power outlet down there. Somewhere. And just slide this desk that way a bit. So it's a bit close to that corner. I might be able to drag it if I take the game, all the games off. I'm not sure where I'm going to put all those PlayStation 2 games, you know. I'm quite full in the game department on here. May have to put some specific shelves in for this.
Duh.
Oh, pardon me. Got wind coming out of all directions. No surprise there, is there? Not with me. Right, some cola down there, put in the fridge. We'll do that later. Yeah, I'm quite intrigued to get this up and running. I was hoping if I left the price sticker on, it would be the the proof of what I paid for it. But sadly, it won't come up on camera. It's just a white sticker. No, I'm just seeing a white sticker. It looks blank, but it isn't. I can assure you it isn't. Oh, well. Didn't much I can do about that, is there? Right. Did I have anything ending tonight on eBay? No. Yeah, no, maybe. Can't remember. Let's have a look at emails. I know you're still. Oh, yeah, I'll have to reply to that. It's not that I don't want to, it's just that I haven't had a chance, because that thing hasn't been working. It works now, though. So, I'll have to print the thingy off and scan it and email it back. That's for the use of my kitchen fail, kitchen design fail video. That Voltage TV want to use, so they can go ahead if they want. But of course they can't without written permission, so that's what I've got to do. I've got to print off the attached form they sent me, fill it in, sign it, scan it back in and email it back. I won't do that tonight, I'll do that tomorrow. But I will just, she sent me an email just checking up, and I will send an email back in a little bit and just explain. I've been waiting these last week, about a week and a half actually, to get this printer up and running. And I'll print it off. Be a good test to make sure the printer's working, because it's been sitting in call it power save mode, where the LED on the power button just flashes and everything else is off. But it hasn't made any difference to my electric consumption, so gonna stay as it is. Ooh, alright. Got a few additions made to this, and that reminds me. Now I know my lighting works fine, I'll get under here and tidy up all the cables. I've got two universal power adapters there. Both exactly the same, it's just one's older than the other, I think. I've got different connectors on. One had, I think about half a dozen various connectors permanently wired to the end. And the other one had replaceable ends. And to change the polarity, you just switch the end round. Because it had arrows and everything on it to tell you. But on the one with the fixed ends, you had to flick a switch. And just from standing up here, I don't know which one's which. getting down there and have a look. Other than that, the actual physical shape and design is exactly the same. The voltage rating is exactly the same, 0 to 12 volt, and I can't remember what the milliamps is, but I've got a feeling they'll be the same anyway. Because I didn't want to put too many on one of them, because I know they're not the most powerful. So I thought I'd just for safety, because they do get rather hot when they're running, not overly hot, but they do give out some heat. But I've basically got the lights in the hospital, that street light, the light in the calf, the two lights in there and that street light, all on one, and then any other lights I add will go on the second one, which is actually running the outside light there, that actually lights up. And I have to say, it's like a bloody mini floodlight, the way that lights up. It's like a scale version, the way it lights up this whole area. It's like a scale version of a floodlight. So, quite impressed with that. Yeah, I might try an orange colour on it. See if that might dim it down a bit. But I've got it on 3 volts and it's still pretty bright. So that's the way I've got that set up. I wouldn't mind doing what my stepdad did on his railways, and that's actually make a, I can't remember what the bloody called it now, like a power bank. In a fuse box you can get like one, maybe two metal rails, which are for the neutral and the earths, and I was thinking of getting a couple of those, fixing them to a board, screwing it somewhere under here, and then have one of those transformers connected to it, one live, one neutral, and then just connect all the other wires for the lights to that. And might make things a little easier and a little tidier. But well, as I've got two transformers, I'd have to have two of those power banks. That's not a power bank, it's something else that was called on his plan, and I can't remember what it was called. But yeah, it's a good idea. I'm going to have to remember to take the camera over. And when it's quiet up in the loft, because I don't know if stepdad would want to be on camera, I'll take the camera up there and give you a look around. But it's coming along nicely, his model railway. Slowly, but nicely. I'm not going to say slowly, I'm going to say steadily. But one of the biggest projects he's doing is electronic points. He's got a little box at the front where all the controller for the engine is going to be, and he's got the a plan drawn on this box of all the where all the points are, and where all the points are he's going to drill a hole and put a switch. He's done 4 now, because he did one earlier today, and there's also 2 colour changing LEDs that change between green and red. Green meaning that track is in use, red meaning it's not in use. And that just basically alternates between them when the point is changed. And you can also hook up signals to do the same thing. but yeah, you reckon that is quite a task just to wire those in. And I think we worked out He's done four, and he's probably got at least another 12 to do. And this is just on a small layout. So, you imagine these people that have, like, big rooms like this, if not bigger, you know, with a railway line going all the way around it, with a huge shuffle yard, as they call it, with loads of sidings. And you have to water up all those electric points to work on the switches. Oh, that must be a nightmare. But, he's getting there. He won't touch anything electrical that's mains operated. But, because that's low voltage, and he is following plans, he can do that. But for some reason, yeah, he wouldn't put anything in like these lights. It's pretty much just the same principle. You know, you follow a diagram, you get diagrams and things online. There's plenty of YouTube videos out there that show you how to do various electrical jobs around the home in various countries. When I say various countries, I've only ever seen it done in... Whoops. I haven't been drinking. Sometimes I'll just lose my balance for some reason. Yeah, I've only ever seen them in the US, Canada, and Britain. Oh dear. Alright. Plans for tomorrow. Can't remember. Oh yeah. Post those three items off, and I think I'll post them first class so I won't actually get the extra 20 pence to myself. That's what I usually do. I charge post items second class at £2.80. And which is stated in the listing, and put an extra 20p on, you know, just for the time to wrap it and pack it and take it to the post office, which I think is bad, really, is it, you know. I could be like some of these e-buyers and put an extra pound on top or something, but now they've waited long enough, so I'm going to do it first class. But someone has actually sent a question. Rather than opening a case, and I wish everyone would do that, rather than open a case. You know, open a case as a last resort. You know, I'm an easygoing person. Well, yeah, right, I've got Asperger's syndrome, you know. So, we can say I've got a mental disorder, if you like. But, oh, actually, speaking of heads, look at this. A haircut. Oh, it's all gone. I've just got to do this now, because I probably look weird. I've got hair here, but not here. This will go. If I don't do it tonight, it'll be done tomorrow. If I remember, I might do it tonight, actually. So, I've got to go to Sainsbury's in the morning to get breakfast. I haven't got nothing in yet. I haven't been at home today to get anything. But yes, someone actually decided to open a case. And the only reason I don't like opening a case is because it holds money back, and the money I sent to my bank, I got cancelled, so I had to resend it minus the money held back for the case. So it's a pain in the backside. But like I said, you know, I'm an easygoing guy. All I've got to do, if they're that concerned, they can message me. Although he's right, I could have messaged him. So is this much my fault? I should have messaged them and said, look, I'm having a bit of trouble getting money from the PayPal to my bank. So there's going to be a delay in postage. Do you want to wait or do you want a refund? You know, I could have easily done that. So yeah, I'll take responsibility. It probably is my fault. But someone else on here has actually sent a message, which I'll reply to in a bit. I'll reply to that lady as well. I've kept the email with that in. I've put that in my Keep Me folder. Honda should have sold tomorrow night. I'm going to message that guy back who messaged me about the Honda. Because he's the only one that's private messaged me, I'll put him in as second in line if this local guy lets me down. I don't think he will. Because, if it's who I think it is, his dad actually runs a quite a successful business in town, so it wouldn't look good, would it? But, yeah, I could always be wrong, but I don't think he will. I'm not sure, but I think I've got him on my friends list. Is he on my friends? Yeah, he is. How about that? You're right, then. First come, first served, so if he turns up tomorrow afternoon, good. It's £100 in my pocket and space in my shed. Like I said, I don't want to actually sell it. But it's something I've been thinking of for quite a while. Because I've had it for over a year now, I would say. It's probably this time last year that I got it. I paid £100 for it back then. So I should get back the £100 at least. I don't mind if he wants to knock me, I don't know, 10, 20 quid, then that's fine. And I'd go, if he's here at 5, that'll give me time just to nip across to the post office and pay my service charge. Mum said not to, because she wants to ring Victory and see if we can get it reduced a little bit, but quite frankly, it's not a problem. Paying 60 every 2 weeks. But my phone bill this time was over 70 quid. It may not sound like a lot to some people, but it is when you don't have a lot coming in the first place. But that was because when I got cut off last month, even though it was just the internet they suspended, they plonked a reconnection charge on me, as well as the late payment charge, which I think I'll get this time as I was late again. But the late payment charge is actually less than the reconnection charge, which I completely forgot about, otherwise I would have done more not to let it get disconnected. I'm going to let it get disconnected again. So that put me a bit short this time, but never mind. Yeah, I've had that Spectrum sitting here a while, in case you're wondering. I just haven't done a video on it. But, yeah, I've still got that lady's bike at Mum's if I want to sell that, so if I think it's worth pissing around doing, because I need to get a grip shift off, but the screw, typically, has rusted in. And using an Allen key, hexagon key, has just rounded the screw off, so that would have to be drilled off, so I've got to think, do I really want to put that much effort into it when I'm only going to sell it for 20 quid tops, if I'm lucky? So I was just going to coat a lot of the black parts with a bit of black paint just to clean it up a bit. But again, you know, I'm not sure I can actually be bothered to really do all that for 20 quid. That's a lot of work. If it just needed the gears and the brake sword then and a clean up, then I'd have probably have been more willing. But I don't know. Maybe if I get really, really bored, I might. Just for something to do. Well, I'll be buggered. eBay are doing it. I'll try again. This is the battery life like. Oh, that's right. eBay have just done a special offer where you can have 43 listings, no insertion fee, and 50% off your final value fee. You had to click the link in the email you got to activate that. So I put a load of stuff up yesterday, including this wheel and the Matchbox cars underneath that were hanging up there, apart from the fire truck, because I want to keep that one. And all 5 out of the 6 that are in the set, I've got a bid on. I put them on separately, with a £2 start bid, and they've all got a £2 bid on. I also put the headlamp lens unit, just the light unit, no bulb holder or anything, which I actually forgot to add in the thing. But they can see there's no wires hanging out the back of it anyway. And that's got a 99p bid on it as well. I just hope the person actually pays for it this time. Because someone bought the indicator light and they didn't pay for it. So that got relisted. My pair of electric bike wheels. Because I put this on as a pair. Front one's in the hallway. That's got a watch on. But I've got a few games up. Few classic bike parts up that don't seem to be doing anything. I've got Driver 2 for PlayStation 1 up here, because I've got two of those games. If they don't sell this time round, I'm going to put them in the pile there for donations and donating to a charity shop, because I know someone will pay a couple of quid from a charity shop for them. I've got Tocker Touring Car Championship. I had two of those, that's why I've got that one on here. What else have I put on here? I've got the Honda Camino rear lamp lens cover. I've got the internals for that as well, but not the actual base, so... A motherboard. A few bike parts. What are the other two games? Guitar Hero. Which Guitar Hero is that? Because I didn't actually look to see if it was like one... Oh, it's Guitar Hero 3, Legends of Rock. Oh, it's only been looked at twice. They ain't going to sell. So I think that will be another one for the charity pile. But I've also decided I'm going to start selling some of my diecast cars off. I do like collecting them, but these days I actually spend more time with the Lego, the road lamps, and the bikes. So it's just something, I haven't even bought a car for the collection for months and months. There's a few things I will keep, like the Matchbox lorries I've got up here. I was thinking about the garbage trucks on there, but I think I'll keep those. There's a couple of boxed ones up there I'll keep. But I think a lot of the rest I've got will probably end up on eBay, not BT, at some point. So, there's no point in me keeping them anymore, so I'll keep them. Excuse me. Sorry about that. I will keep certain ones, the emergency vehicles, because I do like my I've been running that long. I must have been rattling on a bit. Hence why I've got a lot of Lego police and fire and whatnot vehicles. That reminds me, we went to fire service. I don't know if you're going to be able to see because of the light reflection in the window, but we're trying. You can just about... Okay. Yeah, I just see some windows lit up over there. Well, the other side of those buildings is a road. And there's also a few shops, and it seems a light fitting caught fire in one of the shops. It was, according to the live feed, the fire service live feed, it was put out before crews arrived, but they had three crews turn up. That's my dessert for when I'm done with the video, by the way. A couple of shoe buns in there. Can't leave. I don't know if this will reflect the date of the spectrum over there, but this has got a printing date of 1984 in it. So I'm guessing this is at least 1984, which I think would officially make it my oldest computer. I'm pretty certain the Amstrad, the Amstrad's 85, but I don't know about the Dragon 32, I can't remember, I'll have to look that one up. Another Zenith E-Systems laptop is 89? I have had that apart, and I did find a date on a chip in there, but I can't remember. It's either 88 or 89. Yeah, quite an old laptop. Very heavy and very bulky. But sadly, it's got a memory problem, and my electronics isn't good enough to really repair that. So I have sort of debated, do I sell that one? Mind you, it's going to be quite costly on postage, because it's bloody heavy. You know, it's heavy on its own without all the packaging being added to it. Forgot to put these in the fridge. They've been out all day, so they can go in the bin. I'm sure I've got a little bottle of Pepsi somewhere. So I know I bought two this morning, because they were on offer. Why am I putting them in the fridge? I'm not putting them in the bin. Dipstick. Nope, they're not in the fridge. So that Pepsi is in one of these Sainsbury's bags. Going by the shape of it, it's this one. There it is. Oh, the battery's gonna die. No! Well, I suppose what I'll do then, I'll just start again, randomly. What I'll do, when I get round to checking this, which will probably be tomorrow, because I'm not going to Mum's tomorrow or Saturday, get it set up in the bedroom. I do need an RF cable, which I kept deliberately when I was sorting my cables out. I might have been in a throw-out mood because I was pissed off and fed up and depressed, but I wasn't that bad. I did keep cables I knew I would have needed. That is quite bulky for a 9-volt transformer, isn't it? You won't get them that big now. In fact, I've got them the size of actually smaller than those adapters down there. It's amazing how small they can make these power adapters nowadays. Well, for charging phones and whatnot, but I suppose I don't really need a lot, do they? Just something to drop the voltage and a bit of voltage regulation, and that is it. Simple. That's probably why there's bugger all in them now. Anyway, I'll get this hopefully up and running, then I can do a little video on it. Do like this. If I get used to the keyboard layout, because it's got two arrow keys there and two there. Symbol shift. Probably B for all the symbols on here. Plot. Draw. Because you can draw your own pictures with it. Not a clue how. Not until I read through the user guide, wherever I've put it. Let's put it back with the spectrum. Because I would like to learn to use something like this. I do love modern computers, because I love the power of them, you know. I love what they can do nowadays. They're awesome, but I use it every day, so it's not as thrilling as, to me, modern computers aren't as thrilling as getting hold of something that you don't use every day. Like Spectrum. I don't know what I'm going to try and add to the collection after this. But I'm not in any particular hurry, you know, to add. It's just whenever I see a bargain, I don't like to walk away from it. And as soon as I saw this, he's still got three in there, and he's got a small Atari. He did have a large Atari, but that's sold. There's a couple of other consoles from the very early 1980s, maybe late 1970s. You know, the ones that you used to be able to play Pong on and whatnot. You had the two controllers. Oh, if I had 35 quid, I'd have probably bought that as well. I think I'd run out of room in the bedroom quite rapidly, because it's full of computers as it is. The problem with being interested in computers, they do take up a lot of space. I suppose if I cleared out a lot of my Well, I stood up. Oh, that's alright. I cleared out a lot of the computer accessories I've got, like keyboards, from that top cupboard. And again, only kept like two or three that I really need as spares. Then they may not be a problem. I have a bit more room. But that's why my box of PCI cards and video cards, etc., and other expansion cards is so full. Because a lot of it is for older PCs. Well, sort of Windows, at least Windows 95 and onwards. Just for me to, well, build up and get going. And I'm going to get some more consoles, you know. I'm trying to get this in before the battery goes completely. I may have to find another place to put those games. So it would just be consoles on there. But, well, if I actually have a console per shelf like I've already done, then I could get another two on there. Or maybe even put some on the floor. Like the PS2 could go on the floor, actually. Because that's front-loading. Yeah, because ideally I would want computers like the Spectrum and the Amstrad on top, because you need to use the keys. Because I could then move the Mega Drive down to there. I can hear voices. Oh, well, outside, not in my head. I know what you thought as soon as I said that. Yeah. I've got a shelf behind me. I've got a couple of pine planks I can turn into shelves, so if I stack them on the shelves like that, that shouldn't be a problem. Trying to get rid of those cars. There's some of the ones that I will keep, so I will put those in a box with the rest of my oldies. But I suppose at the right price, if someone offered me something for the boxes I've got in the cupboard of cars, just for the whole box, I'd probably let them go. Anyway, I think I've rambled on enough for this one. That is coming up to about a 40-minute video. If you're wondering what that flash was in the window, it was just the lights on the PC flashing. Yeah, I'm getting a bit peckish because I want my shoe buns. And I've got to take my pills and I need a drink and need to probably take a crap and a piss and everything else with it, so I'm going to disappear. I'm going to plan, or run a few things around in my head to plan, perhaps plan where I'm going to put some shelves in the bedroom. I'm going to shuffle around in there. Yeah. So, thanks a lot for watching this rather long video, if you made it this far through it. And, as always, if you liked the video, thumbs up. If you haven't subscribed, please subscribe. I do put up videos daily on this channel. If you're interested in Lego, then search for my BrickNut 30 channel, which is my Lego channel. And yeah, again, thanks for watching, and I'll talk to you again soon. Bye.